So here's a black and white CAD drawing that shows the layout of the steel that we're going to put in our Revit structure. It's included in the folder, and it's showing you, let's just zoom in a little bit, that the columns, this column on the right here, is going to be 2 foot by 2 foot, which is 24 by 24, obviously. And we're going to put number 14 bars in it all around the corners. You don't have to know why we're putting number fours in. It's based on the code, what's the load it has to carry. The spacing is according to the code. The number five tie is according to the code. But we're going to just draw this frame, and it's got all the dimensions on it. And then we're going to add the steel. And you can see here's the beam that I started with, a 16 by 28. It's got some number eight bars on the top. And again, if you look at the drawing, here's the number eight bars in the top because there's tension right here. I need these pieces of steel. And the 8 foot, this 8 foot, is what the code requires. And you'll learn about that in concrete design. Right now, we're just going to try and put these bars up there, make them about 8 feet from the face of the column. And then we're going to put some stirrups in. If you look right here, the beam stirrups. That's these little pieces here. And if you go down here, that's sort of the bar that goes all the way around the cross section. That's a stirrup. And then at the bottom, we have number 10 bars. And if you look at that in our beam, we have number 10 bars right here. And it points to the bars right here at the bottom. And those bars have to go typically 6 inches past the center of support by code. So they're going to go across like that, 6 inches past this center of support over here. And when you load a building, you will get uneven steel, meaning you could put symmetrical steel if you want to do the worst, or if you want to design it to exactly the load. On the left side, I may have some weird loads because I've got some 30-foot spans, and this column is in the middle of a 30-foot span and a 25-foot span, so the steel may change on this side, and that's what I've done. I've got number nines up the top here, and they go for 8 feet and 7 feet. And on the bottom, still number tens, because you can't switch the bottom steel from one column to the next column. But I've included this. Look through it, see if it makes sense. It's got all the dimensions that we're going to use for our frame, and this frame is just the same frame that is repeated a number of times for the building. So if we draw this one frame, we can just copy array it. All right, so this is what we're going to start with. So take a look.